Hello and welcome. In this specific video, I'm going to show you how to take a screenshot of a sales letter. So you can use this on sales letters. You can apply it to anything other than sales letters. It doesn't have to be sales letters, but I'm going to show you how to take screenshots so that you can properly do them, resize them to the proper size, and then you can upload them to your tabs. Now, there are several screenshot softwares out there that you can use. I prefer to use Snagit. So if you go to techsmith.com/snagit.html, you will be able to see a little more information about what Snagit offers. Snagit offers not only just screenshots, but you can do a lot more than just the basic screenshots. And I'll show you in a minute just how to do that, and of course what we're looking at. Now, if you don't want to dish out some money, I believe it's about $50, then you can always stick with free programs. There is a Firefox webpage screenshot software. If you go to add-ons.mozilla.org/fireshot. So, or you can simply just do a search for Fireshot or do a search for web page screenshot in Firefox. There's a lot of them out there that you can use. But obviously, you will need to have Firefox in order to use this. Now, in this specific video, I'm going to be using Snagit just because I prefer that. I use it all the time, and there's a lot of cool stuff that you can actually do with it. So let's take, for example, a sales letter here. Here's a sales letter that is about outsourcing book writing and proofreading. Now, keeping that in mind, you have to know what kind of tabs you're going to create. So if I'm going to create a basic general tab that gives people the idea of the headline, the subheadline, and what it's all about. And then I can move in a little more deeper, perhaps into relating to the person. Now, keep in mind that these are deal pages. It doesn't necessarily give us the ability to put too much text in there. In fact, during our case studies, we found that if you put too much text, most people will not look through all your text. With a deals page, you want it to be super fast and quick. So keeping that in mind, I think we're going to stick with possibly just doing this here. We're going to give them a breakdown of the 10-part video series so they know exactly what to expect. We could put some images in here because the deals page is going to have the header already, so we don't have to put the header. And they can have a side block, can be either an image or video, so you could either put the images in the side block or a video itself. And I'm going to take a screenshot of the 10-part video series breakdown here, and I think at the very end I could put some call to actions, but just three tabs in this case. So what I need to do now is simply open up Snagit here. And it's very, very easy to use, but in this case, we're going to cover two different ways, actually. But the first thing we'll want to do is grab this here. So if I open up Snagit here, we want to choose the region feature. As long as everything is above the fold and you can see it, the region is just fine. So I would say pick anywhere here. Copy it here and just make sure that over here it's about aligned correctly. So that'll be kind of the first intro. Then I want to get a breakdown of the actual video series. Or I could grab this here. So I'm going to grab this here. Now, if you're wondering, okay, the text actually goes beyond above the fold, I'll show you how to do that in just a minute. But we're going to go ahead and do the same thing here. I'm going to grab Dear So-and-So. And there we go. Now, let me show you this. Because it goes past here, I'm going to have to use the scroll feature. So with Snagit, I'm going to have to move this a little bit over here so that you can see this. But with Snagit, I'm going to do the scrolling window. And then I'm going to make sure that it auto scrolls to the window. That way it'll scroll down, it'll capture it while it's scrolling down. So I'm going to select capture, and I'm going to click on this little scroll arrow that goes down. And as you can see, it's copying, it scrolled it down, and then it made the screenshot. So now I press control down here so I can see the whole thing. But as you can see, I kind of want it to stop here. So I'm going to simply drag the bottom arrow here all the way here. And I don't really want this background here, so I'm just going to move all this over here and all of this over to here. And I'm going to make it look decent like this. And there we go. Now, the thing I like about Snagit is you can actually add stuff to this. You don't have to use it as it is, like most other screenshot softwares. You can add arrows if you want to. You can make them 3D. You can add other types of arrows. You can add other types of effects. You can even highlight stuff if you want to. You can change the color of the highlight. You can add callouts. You can add stamps. You can do a lot of other types of things. But besides that, you can also make it look like this. So you can have it like it's a piece of paper that's been ripped out. You can even make it have that kind of 3D effect to it. You can change that 3D effect however you want to. You can make it sideways like that. That's another good eye-catching feature. And of course, you can resize it. Now, in terms of the width that you should have it no wider than 750 pixels for a standard deal page. Now, in terms of a narrow deal page, if you want to use it for WordPress iframes, Facebook tabs, or for mobile users, then the max would be 650 pixels wide. So just keep that in mind here. So I'm thinking, I know I've got iPhone and mobile users that will come to the page. I want to make sure that I appeal to them as well. So I'm going to make it 650 width max. So the way you do it is simply click on resize and resize image. And just take a look at it what it is in pixels. Now the width here is 669. So just to be safe, I'm going to make it 640. You can do it anything you want, and just want to make sure that the height is adjusted in relation to the width. So that we got that there. I'm going to go here. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to resize the image, make sure that it is less than 650. So I'm going to do 640. And I'm going to do the other image, same thing here. We're going to resize the image and choose pixels. And this is too big, so I'm going to make it 640. And there we go. So from that point, all I have to do is save it, click save, save the files, and of course, watch my videos on how to upload to the tabs through the editor that we give you. So as you can see, very, very easy to use, doesn't take a long time, and you don't necessarily have to do it with Snagit. You can use the other software that I pointed you to. As you can see here, we recommend this, or you can use your own screenshot software. So that's it.